up and then died. Like, go right ahead. Didn't mean to interrupt. Your guys' part. I'm just worried about my part. See? You do whatever you want.
Okay.
Thanks. Tattooed rings, which I guess is a thing now. No, what they did was, and they didn't tell me because they didn't want me to, whatever. But they used pop, what they call ring pops. So I asked for the rings, and they brought out two ring pops. But they exchanged ring pops. Yes. Yeah. Tattooed rings, because, but the ring pop, I don't know. I mean,
thank you.
Harder technology.
Thank you.
Okay. please rise. You may be seated. Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the presence of this company to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony. Marriage is an honorable estate instituted by God, blessed by our Lord Jesus, and declared by St. Paul to be honorable among all. It is not, therefore, to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, soberly, advisedly, and in the fear of God. Let's pray. Father, we are grateful that we have been invited to witness this uniting of two of your children. In the garden, at the first wedding, you were the only witness. You pronounced them man and wife. We carry on that sacred tradition today. We ask for your blessings on them. When things get tough, we pray that they will remember these promises that they are making to each other and think of the witnesses who heard and saw it. Amen. We're going to sing "Great is Thy Faithfulness." It's in your program.
Thank you. Can I take this off? Ephesians 5:21-33. Submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives, submit to your own husbands as you do to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, his body, of which he is the Savior. Now, as the church submits to Christ, also wives should submit to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing of the water through the word, and to present her to himself as a radiant church, without strain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. In the same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. After all, no one ever hated their own body, but they feed and care for their body just as Christ does the church. For we are members of his body. For the reason a man will leave his father and mother and to be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a profound mystery, but I am talking about Christ and the church. However, each one of you also must love his wife as he loves himself, and the wife must respect her husband.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man? I now charge you both, as you stand in the presence of Almighty God, to remember that true love and the faithful observance of your wedding vows are required as the foundation of a successful marriage and the establishment of a happy and enduring home. Without these, there can be no real marriage, and the home which you will endeavor to establish will be a vain effort. Keep the solemn vows you're about to make. Live with tender consideration for each other. Conduct your lives in honesty and in truth. Your marriage will last. Your home will endure. The marriage bond will be a blessing to you, and you will be a blessing to others. This should be remembered as you now declare your desire to be wed. Edward, do you take this woman to be your wife? Do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses that you will love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and that forsaking all others for her alone, you'll perform unto her all the duties that a husband owes to his wife until God by death shall separate you?
I do.
Alison, do you take this man to be your husband? Do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses that you will love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and that forsaking all others for him alone, you will perform unto him all the duties that a wife owes to her husband until God by death shall separate you?
I do.
Since it is your desire to take each other as husbands and wife, please repeat after me and before God and these witnesses the marriage vows. I, Edward, take thee, Alison, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance, I pledge to you my faithfulness. I, Alison, take thee, Edward, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer
or for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance, I pledge to you my faithfulness. Rings, please. Alison, do you take this ring from Edward as a token of his affection, sincerity, and fidelity towards you? And will you wear it as a symbol of your own affection, sincerity, and fidelity towards him? Edward, repeat after me. With this ring,
I thee wed,
in token and in pledge of our constant faith and abiding love. With this ring, I thee wed, and all my earthly goods I thee endow. Edward, will you take this ring from Alison as a token of her affection, sincerity, and fidelity towards you? And will you wear it as a symbol of your own affection, sincerity, and fidelity towards her? Allie, well, repeat after me. This ring I give thee,
in token and in pledge
of our constant faith
and abiding love.
With this ring,
I thee wed,
and with all my earthly goods,
I thee endow.
We're going to sing Standing on the Promises.
Standing on the promises of our Savior, Savior, Savior.
For as much as Edward and Alison have consented together in holy wedlock and have pledged the same before God and these witnesses and have given to each other their faith, I have declared by the giving and receiving of a ring, I declare by the authority committed unto me as a minister of the gospel that they are husband and wife, according to the ordinance of God and the law of this state, in the name of the Father and the Son and of the Holy Spirit, those whom God has joined together, let no man put asunder. You may now kiss the bride. I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Edward Jones.
Thank you. they might just be.